Hey, InstaFam, what's up? Hey, 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 this is Ebony from Queens, Recognize Queens, an empowerment brand here to help you self-discover, self-love, and just live life to the fullest because that's what we got to do. So I have had this on my heart for about 2 days now, and I'm like, it's so perfect that we're going into Martin Luther King Day because I'm talking about how you think will free you. When we talk about real freedom and, you know, these gems that have been dropped on us for years, it's really time that we start implementing them and like living up to an MLK type dream and like really even invoking the spirit and the courage and the wisdom that he had. So thank you so much for joining me. Hopefully this is not cut out. Typically I go live on Facebook rather than Instagram, but I am on Instagram today. So hey, 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 how are you? Happy Sunday. This will be a really awesome, soulful chat. I'm gonna be switching up the way that I do my posts. I think it would be better to just do a motivational post on a Sunday because that's the day when we're, for me, I know, I'm thinking the most and I'm rejuvenating, and if, you know, I'm getting ready and prepared for what's happening within the week, right? So if you're with me, hello, hello. If you're somewhere else in the world, what is up, London? I see you guys. What is up? Let's see who else. Where's my girl Rostov? I can't even think right now because I'm just so excited to share this message with you. I'm so excited to be on Instagram. Typically, Facebook, I get so much love with the videos. You know, on Instagram, just a little different, probably because I don't go live as much. So hello, hello, hello. If you're joining me, I'm going to be talking about how to think so it frees you. And I shared a post the other day on Facebook, and I was saying, you know, we really have to learn to change our, hello, Bella Pelskin. That's you. If I said that right, hey, 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 I will check your page out after this. Changing your them to I, and I kind of gave examples of saying, like, you know, they don't like me. Let's change that. I love myself. You know, they'll never accept me. You know, I accept myself, and I know and I trust myself that I will bring the opportunities that are in alignment with me. And it's just, we have to keep constantly changing that, because I think, I know, you know, just the way that the world is right now, it's like you have to focus on faith, you have to focus on what you're doing and all the good you're doing and yourself, and like, who am I going to be in this world that we're in, what am I going to do, how am I going to contribute, you know, how am I going to be of service? And that's what I really want to do. I just want to be of service and just live up to my fullest potential. And I think, you know, once you've mastered certain self-mastery skills and you keep doing it and you keep investing in it, like, trust and believe your life is going to go to wherever you want it to be. And even going back to that Martin Luther King mentality and just the courage and invoking that spirit of that was within him, it came from the same source that we all are part of. So why wouldn't we be able to tap into that and to really, really, really invoke what he was saying? Because everybody celebrates Martin Luther King, you know, but we have to start doing and do less of talking and reposting pictures, like, you know. And this perfect segment into what I was also saying was another thing too, is we're judging people more than we're empowering them. And it happens on so many levels, and judging on any level, we really have to check ourselves. I shared a video today on Facebook of Gabby Bernstein, because judging other people comes from a source that's not of love. You know, you don't judge in love, and you just want to do everything out of love because that's how you get more love. Like, it just starts with you. Whatever you give out, you will get back. And the best way to catch yourself, because none of us are perfect, I'm not sitting here like I've been perfect all my life. This is a journey. This has been a journey. This is a journey I will be on forever. Because I think, I know, we never stop learning, and that is what we have to do. So we have to just keep blooming, keep blossoming, keep growing, keep reinventing. And it's just this constant cycle of, you know, caterpillar, cocoon, butterfly, cat, you know, and you'll grow into yourself. And Eric Thomas talks about this all the time. I freaking love Eric Thomas because he has so much energy behind what he's talking about. And I love it because You know, life can be simple. Like it really can. And I trust and I believe that life can be so simple. We choose to make it complicated. Folks gotta stop with the judgment. Absolutely. And we all know, you know, we don't even have to name the people who are always doing it. And I even shared a post today because February 1st, I will be wearing a hijab. And I'm like, seriously though, Catholic Christian nuns wear hijabs in their own little way, and no one's judging them, you know. And it's like people just don't think about things, they don't put piece it together in a way that's, you know, it's like ignorance is bliss. Like, I'm just gonna believe what I'm gonna believe, I'm gonna live my life and fight for my right to just always be right. No, like, doesn't work like that. So you have to always think about what you're thinking about. That's what Eric Thomas talks about. That's the best way for you to start changing your them out there. I can't change life. I'm a victim. This is too hard. Whatever the thought is that's not helping you, you have to change it to I. What can I do? Right? For me, sometimes I feel like, oh my goodness, I don't have enough space. Well, what I'm gonna have to do with the little space that I do have with what I'm doing right now is maximize it. Go to IKEA, get these little things that are gonna maximize that level so that's not a stressor for me. Because for me, I love things to be neat and tidy and you can find them and you've, you know, balanced. So you have to think about what you're thinking about constantly. And you know where you're at if your mood is not well. That's the indicator, right? That your mood is not well, so you are not well. Your thoughts are probably they're feeding that moment, and you have to think about it. And just go back to the source of like, okay, why am I thinking about this? And it changed those thems to I. What can I do? Or even if it's sometimes for me what really works is simple. Two things that I've been doing. So one thing to just change that thought quickly is to say, I'm amazing. I'm great. I'm so amazing. Because you have to like be your own cheerleader and pep yourself up no matter where you're at, no matter how you look. You know, because women, we pick ourselves apart. You know, oh my God, I look so fat. We all know. Like, we all know. We do it too much to the point to where we do it to each other. And today, actually, when I was showering, I'm like, I need to talk to like all these female rappers. I love the ones that are real, like a Cardi B, and I think that's why everybody loves her. That's why I love her, because she's so authentic. And that people are trying to find the formula to be authentic, and there's no formula other than just be yourself. And if people like you, they like you. They don't like you, they don't like you. Whatever. You have to move like that, but you have to love yourself, and you have to just be dope and just be yourself and mix things up and try different things that you like and switch your style up. Like, just keep reinventing yourself. And like I said, saying to yourself in those moments when you feel down and you feel like shit, if you keep saying to yourself, I am the shit, you feel down. This is a moment you feel down. Feel this with me, okay? You feel down, you're not feeling it, you're at home in your pajamas, you're like, okay, I look crazy, whatever. You know? And you just say to yourself, I'm the shit. You just keep saying, I am the shit. I am the shit. And eventually it's gonna be like, yo, I am the shit. Throw on some music. I throw on music all the time because music pumps you up. When you got stuff on, what do you do when you're going out to a club? Everybody's getting hype. Ah, we about to go out. Okay. Do that when you're in the moments when you don't feel well. Not just when you're going to the club. We have to take these principles that we've learned and readjust them in ways that benefit us. Because we kind of get it and we've all got the same information. We all can tap into God and source and where we come from if we choose. And it's your choice to say, I want that. Like, I want to be there. I want to do that. I want to, but you're overthinking it. So while you're thinking, you have to analyze your thoughts and do analytics on your thoughts and insights on your thoughts. And just as much as you study when you go to school, you need to study your thoughts. What am I thinking and why am I thinking that? Ooh, like, I feel unworthy when I think about that. Ooh, that hurts. And it's okay. But while you're thinking about it, you're gonna help yourself heal because you're acknowledging it. And that's the first step to recovery, right? So, also, the other thing is if you're not committing to you and your mind, because your mind and the way you think will free you, right? Let's talk about MLK. I have a dream that freedom is possible, and I know it starts with your mind. So your time, if you don't make it important, if it's not important to you to invest in your mind, if meditating might help you, writing, these are tools that actually work. You know, these are tools that actually have been proven to help people get through life for years. Poetry, just writing different things, music, things that make you happy. They They will help you, and investing in your mind is going to be the best thing that you will ever do. With any book that I would buy, psychology books, I can't even think of this. I always get the name wrong. Metaphysics, just science in general. I've always loved science because it all is mapped out for us, and everything is available to all of us if we choose to see it. It really is. It's so simple. It's all there, and it begins with your mind. So you need to make the time. And you need to find it important just as you would find anything else, because that's the key to your life. You have to construct the change. You have to construct what you want. It's not going to come to you. And we go through life like it kind of boggles my mind a little bit, and I do think about this, because like when people get accepted to like Ivy League schools, I'm like, okay, so a human being just like you created that school. And there's tons of people who are recreating schools as we speak. Different schools. Oprah created a school, okay? And then said, you know, you have to be certain kind of person, certain kind of smarts, whatever it is, class, to come to this school, right? And then that's developed. And then we're like, oh my God, I got into Harvard. Like, really? Like, you are limitless. Of course you can get into Harvard, because the person who created it came from the same source as you. So of course that's possible. You can get into any college that you want, you know, and you can't get it by with slacking and not hard work and bad habits and overthinking too much. And you know, and if you are going to take that path in life, then you have to learn how to maximize it and to really expunge that college experience and take everything you can from it, because even in college there's a ton of resources that people don't tap into. So you have to be smart, and even in college you have to start planning about where you want to go in your mind when you leave that job. Because I'm telling you, as a director, I would have to tell people who had degrees, you're gonna get paid $11 an hour. That's not cool. And we all know this when they're like, you don't have experience. Duh. Like, I went from college, you know, I went from high school to college. Like, of course I don't have experience. My experience is like Starbucks and working fast food, because that's all I could do while I was in school, you know? So thank you so much. Leap of faith. Hey, I love your movement. I love what you're doing. Like, I love seeing people everywhere just doing amazing things. So when people say, oh my God, is the world going to change? I'm like, absolutely. I see it changing. And although to everybody else, it looks like only 100 people, let me keep it real. Evil or whatever you want to call it, the key of understanding this, all of this, they have better marketing. That is it. They have better marketing. They have a bigger budget than Queens Recognize Queens. That's what I'm trying to say. But I am here, and other people like Leap of Faith, they are changing the world, the perspective, and helping people see that there is good in the world. And the more good that you see in the world, the more you're inspired to be good and to do good and to find that good so you can partake in it too. Because we're all having a great time, and we're like, I don't care what's going on, I'm fitting to smile and live life, because life is good all the time. All the time. So, thank you guys so much for joining me too, by the way. I really appreciate you. So make it important to you. You don't want it. You really don't want it. You have to either really, really want it, or you just kind of want it. You have to want it really bad. Eric Thomas, go back to, if you want to look on YouTube, at this speech that he did a long time ago when he first started, called How Bad Do You Want It? Phenomenal speech ever. And recently he talked about something where he asked the girl, he said, if I was to say, you know, you need to meet me here at such and such time in the morning, you know, 6 in the morning, and I'm gonna give you $1 million, where would you be? She was like, I would be right there. Everybody would say that. And then if it's other things, you just don't find it important. Why is that so important that you would show up? You know, we have to change our minds so that we start shifting what we find important, because we know the end goal really does bear fruits that are worth it, other than working hard to do all these other things that, you know, sometimes take us off our path and frustrate us a little bit more. And, you know, you're still trying to figure out life, and you can figure it out quicker by starting with your mind and empowering it, and keep empowering it and feeding it great things. A lot of other times, this is just, I have to, it's a snippet. This is like a whole different conversation. I could have a whole live about this, which is, we're waiting for a fire. We are waiting for a fire in order to change. We don't want it that bad. And sometimes some of us, I've been there where I need to be pushed out of that situation to push through it, to say, oh, I shouldn't be there. You know, and it's not a good habit. It's very stubborn. You're not paying attention to the signs of life. You're not paying attention to where your alignment is or where your mood is or where you want to go. And you're just, you know, and we have to get out of that habit of waiting for a fire, waiting for it to be at a point where it's too bad to change. But things can always be changed. You know, sometimes you just have to work on it. It's like think of it as like a train and you're going. You know, when you lose momentum, you have to then build it back up again. And that's okay. And I think that happens throughout life. And I really do believe that the worst challenges we will ever go through will build the best in us only if we let them and see it like that. You know, first is a lot of fucking anger. I will get into my tea coming up this month, beginning February. But, you know, that's just what life does to us. And we have to allow it to make us better, not bitter. So let's stop waiting for the fires. And also, a lot of times in that moment where you have fear or uncertainty about something, it's usually meaning you need to go do it. You need to go do it. And we focus so heavily on fear and how fear makes us feel. The acronym that is just so amazing and so true is fear is false evidence appearing real. It's not real. What's real danger and why you should be fearful is like getting chased by an elephant. Or something not friendly, like, you know, that's fear. But when we apply it to applying for a job, doing what you love, jumping out of a plane, I know that sounds crazy, I have to do it though, because I'm like, ah, that would be so cool. You know, just these things of life, we're fearful of it, we're fearful to take that step. And I always give the analogy of Michael Jackson, because he was an icon of like leaving us puzzles in his song, you know, Man in the Mirror. All his songs were just like, yo, the future generation listening to this, like, listen to this. Even Kanye, there's certain artists that when you really listen to them, I'm like, yo, they're like trying to tell you something, but they got a little beat going on, right? Love them. Kendrick Lamar, woo, well, David Banner, great people. Anywho, so if you feel like you fear it, run towards that. Run towards it. Will Smith talks about it, run towards it. Your mind, okay, and I'm going to end with this because these are truthful facts. You Google them, because Google is like God, you know, God of just knowledge. You can find things that are reliable. But just talking about the brain, it's the most powerful organ that we possess. That's really a big deal. That's really a big deal. You have this superpower thing and you can do whatever you want with it, with your mind. And it's the best asset that you have. It's like buying stocks. You need to buy into that stock. If there's any stock you're going to buy into, first and foremost, it has to be your mind. It has to be your mind. We don't practice thinking skills enough to be effective, but we can. It's super simple. Going back to the beginning, think about what you're thinking about and adjust it and fix it. Dance to music. Pump yourself up. Be your cheerleader. Believe in yourself. Tell yourself, I am great. I am amazing. I am phenomenal. I am fierce. I am light. I am love. I give love. I receive love. Just keep going with it until you feel pumped, because you can work yourself out of that. You really, really, really can. The more you do it, the more you practice it. If you're someone who gets anxiety a lot and you're just an overthinker, I've experienced like physical anxiety before as well. Some people have it really bad. I think my case was like, all right, I dealt with it through meditation and just like really thinking about what I was thinking about. And it helped me to calm myself down. You have to be able to find your center. That's what it's about. You find your center so that everything looks clear. Because when you don't have your center, it's kind of like you're rocking and you're trying to look at everything that's going on. You can't, because it's not clear to you. And you feel unclear and you feel uncertain. It's all bullshit. Just sit down, get calm, relax. It's okay. Everything is available to you when you choose to seek it, because it's seeking you. You just haven't sat down and said, okay, I'm listening. you know, we pray, everybody prays, pray for Haiti, pray for this. Like, do you sit down and really think about those countries? And like, that's the energy we have, and that's what we possess, the most powerful organ that we possess, the pineal gland. Look it up. It's in Stargate in your brain. It's the craziest thing. I watched something on the History Channel the other day where they were saying aliens implanted it. That's how crazy it is. But whatever, however you believe about it, it's just, look it up. It's amazing. Atomic energy to build the world's major cities times over. So that's how much energy your brain packs, is it could build the biggest cities in the world times and times and times again over. You are capable. You are amazing. You can do anything. We can do anything. I had to take a picture of it, but I was like, I have to show y'all my tattoo that I did. I gave myself my own little crown tattoo because I was like, I know I could do this. It looked so simple to me, and it came out pretty good. Like, I'm not gonna go like giving myself a million tattoos. However, for that one, I was like, I did a good job. Because you can do anything. You are limitless. And the more you buy into that over how unworthy you are and reliving your childhood and judging people who have hurt you, and you know, like, when we judge them, we want to make them feel bad. Hurt people, y'all. We got to get out of these cycles that we're in, that we've learned, you know, this selfishness. You can be selfish, but you have to be selfish with love. That's how you change the world. It took me time to grow here and to be here, but that's what I learned, and it works. Because I don't want it any other way. Like, life is just too short, and the worst thing to do is to have to look at a certain situation or look back on your life and not feel happy that you at least lived out of joy. You know, and you deserve it. You have the atomic brain energy, the most powerful organ that you possess. It's a stock. It's an asset to you, available to you every single day. And it's your choice to tune into it. And it's your choice. So, Monday motivational pep talk. If you guys are across the world, if you're in India, hey guys, Africa, I see you guys. Hey. Happy Sunday going into Monday. Stay motivated, stay blessed, stay in the light, because that is what is going to keep fueling you when you just keep seeking it. You keep seeking it. That's all you have to do. It's so simple. Invest in it. It's the biggest stock that you have, okay? How you think will free your mind. Thank you so much for joining me. As always, real, recognize real. Queens, recognize queens. Check out my amazing interview with American Real. I've shared some stuff on Facebook. You can find me at Queens, Recognize Queens on Facebook as well as Eb Tutora, Tutora. As long as you're positive, I will accept your friend request. I'm not into having a ton of friends just so I can, no, I don't need numbers. I need good friends who share good stuff and spread the good vibes. Spirit fingers, y'all. So thank you so much for joining me. Lots of love, lots of light. Have an amazing day. Keep reaching for your dreams. They are possible once you buy into that they are possible, because you could do anything. I love you guys so much. Have a great day. And if you're in the 607, my brunch on purpose is next Sunday. I have so many great things planned for 2018. I'm going to be all over, especially in New York City. Look out for me in New York City. I am coming to hang out with my tribe out there. I love you guys. Thank you so much for supporting me and supporting this movement. Again, Happy New Year. I don't care. I feel like you could say it till January 31st. It is 2018, and this is your decade, you know, quote unquote, less brown. Let's get it, okay? Have a great day. Thank you guys so much. Click the link in my bio. You can view my site as well as get your pre-purchase tickets for Brunch on Purpose. Love you guys. Have a good night.